Should I just make my content upgrades freely available to download for anyone who comes to the show notes page, or should I make them opt in to get the bonus content?
Great question. So it really depends. If your goal is just to get people on the phone because your business model is high ticket and you don't use email marketing, it's really fine not to have them download. So because you already have a great CTA for your season anyhow, and you're really working with folks at a very high price point, and you're really focused on the few prospects opposed to the many, honestly, I wouldn't even bother making people opt in for this in your case, because your entire website is really built as a go-to resource. So the people who are going to become your buyers, they're already contacting you by phone, by email. They want to talk to you directly. So make sure that anything you do put out is fully branded. I know you already know this, but make sure it's got some nice branding on it and clickable links so that the branding will automatically take them back to your website. And then you may even want to specifically, down in the footer, put the title of the episode or the something that says see more or for more about this topic, go, click here or something like that. So that way, if your resource is getting shared, somebody might get it and then they're talking to somebody else who also needs to sell a house or whatever. They may want to just pass on, forward it to their friend instead of having them go to your website. So make sure for sure that anybody who gets a hold of that document is able to get back to your website and that they can see, oh, there's more value right from that thing. And so in your case, I would not use opt-in because you don't need to build your list beyond what you're already doing. Now, if your business revolved around, if it was driven by a funnel, if you had a lower ticket entry point and it was more of a volume business, then I would say you want to consider doing the opt-in probably because then you can put the person through the funnel. But most likely anybody who, in your case is coming to the show notes page, they're already engaging with you. They've already opted in for your list or they're not interested in opting in for your list. So there's no need to capture their email. Does that make sense?
Yeah. So what kind of, would you include any sort of call to action at the bottom along with the branding and everything? Like, I know you said have a website so they can go to it, but would you include any sort of call to action there as well so that if they are sharing it, it's sort of that word of mouth type thing? And
yeah, good question. So I would say I would just have something in the footer that says excuse me, check out my podcast episode about topic at, and then you can put the address for that show notes page if you want to do that. But otherwise, don't put too much effort or thought into this. Keep it really simple because your people, just make sure that whoever gets a hold of it can get back to you. But other than that, I wouldn't make it more complicated than it has to be. You are going to be creating so many different resources all the time. And so just in your episodes, even, as a part of your template, you'll want to make sure that at the end, part of your outro or just before your outro, you'll want to make sure that you're saying something visit the show notes page for this episode. You'll find whatever, whatever, whatever on the show notes page, as well as additional free resources that you can download to help you with blah, blah, blah. Or you can even say per episode what that specific content upgrade is. So you're incentivizing your listener even more so to go to the show notes page. Does that make sense?
Yeah,